Right? I mean, you got basketball.
Yes.
Playoffs. That's big in my house. That's big in a lot of people's houses right now. But for me, the big storyline was, you know, last night, Golden State was playing the Lakers. And the winner plays the Phoenix Suns. And everyone wanted Golden State to win because they don't think the Phoenix Suns can beat the Lakers.
It's going to be a tough one for sure. I think we have a better chance with the Warriors.
We? You're that in now that yes. We are we?
Yes, we are one.
Well, for me, when I watch Laker games, I always look for famous people. Uh-huh. And it's hard now with masks. But I saw Drake and Michael B. Jordan courtside.
Isn't that crazy? Because they were just hanging out the other day. Like, Drake posted a picture hanging out with LeBron and Michael B. Jordan. Yeah. And then they were at the game, and they kept going to them. And I'm like, keep going to them. Yeah. They're so gorgeous.
I was like, and then I come up with a storyline of, like, how do they become friends? Because there's not, because Michael B. Jordan is recently famous. You know what I mean? I mean, and Drake's been famous for at least 10 years. Yeah. At least. So I'm like, how did that happen? Do they both know they're famous? And they're like, hey, we're famous. Maybe we should go to this game. You know what I mean? And I don't even pay attention to the basketball game. All I'm worried about is concerned is how their friendship happened and how they got those great seats. And do they like having the masks on? Do they know people are going to recognize them with the mask on? And I'm like, I really recognize them with their masks on.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And are they working on something? So, like, why are you guys hanging out?
Because he just did, Michael B. Jordan is directing Creed. He just finished directing Creed 3.
Uh-huh.
So I'm like, is Drake doing the soundtrack? Like, what is up?
Mm,
you know what I mean?
Okay.
So anyway, I don't even know who won the game.
The Lakers won.
So anyway. In dramatic fashion.
So also, I got to tell you guys, my bird problem has been solved.
No way.
Yes. Have you heard about the bird? The bird
is well, everybody's heard about the bird.
Yeah, so I got this bird problem, this crazy, crazy bird problem in my house. And I mean, this bird problem is so solved, I don't even hear a tweet, a peep, nothing in the bushes anymore. It's like they got rid of the birds within a 10-mile radius of my house.
They go nuclear?
There's no birds.
I know, so...
Atomic bomb in the backyard?
What did they do to the birds?
So there were birds in my chimney. There's birds on this porch of our balcony. There are birds everywhere. And it's like, I think the birds knew this company was coming that we hired because they came yesterday morning at 7 a.m., but the day before... The birds that were in the bushes, they were just gone. So I don't know what happened to the birds in the bushes. They were gone. The ones that attacked my dogs.
You didn't see what they did to get rid of them?
They didn't do anything to the birds in the bushes. I think the birds in the bushes knew. Hey, man, these guys are coming. We better get the hell out of here.
Get out.
But the birds in the balcony, what they did is they put up this net. I put it on my stories last night. At night, I don't think it's a big deal. You can't. It's a black net. In the daytime, it might be like an ugly looking thing. You know what I mean? But it's in the backyard, so who cares? So, like, picture you have, like, a porch. Picture, like a tent with a net. Just a net. It's a giant net over the porch. So if the birds come flying into the porch, bam, they're going to have to bounce off the net.
Ooh.
And then they put all over our roof this thin wire all over the roof. So if the bird tries to land on the wire's loose, and so it can't get stable, so the bird will fly off. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
But if the bird flies into the wire, it'll cut them in half.
Okay,
poor
that's
birdie.
Pleasant.
Right. Yeah, so I put them up on my Facebook. If you go to Johnjay Van Ness on Facebook, you can see I put the name of the company. I put pictures up. I put everything up on Facebook and tagged them.
It's going to be weird that it's so quiet because you're used to hearing all the chirping at all hours.
Well, I haven't been able to. It happened last night. So, I mean, I got up at 3 o'clock in the morning, 2:30 in the morning. So I haven't been able to. For me, the weekends, the birds chirp at 5:15 in the morning.
That'll be the real test.
That'll be the big test. But they're not in. And they come up on the roof and they, because there was bird, you know, feathers and poop everywhere. They got up on the roof and power washed our roof.
Oh, that's
awesome. You know what I mean?
Nice.
So they got rid of all that crap that was up there. And they put up little nets in the, like, what do you call it? Like, you know, like your roof is like this. And then
pitched roof?
Yeah, but then there's the little ones underneath, the little awnings. They put nets where the birds would go make little nests. So there's just no birds. They're gone. They're done. And it was beautiful to see. Because they were so ugly. The birds, you know, pigeons, they make all this crappy mess. They're just, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Everywhere.
Gross.
Everywhere.
And your poor dogs.
Yeah, the dogs got attacked by the birds. The kids got attacked. Because there was different birds, pigeons and these things called grackles. They're done. And those hummingbirds, they're out.
What?
Oh, I like the hummingbirds.
Wait, no.
I'm just kidding about the hummingbirds.